What's up, San Diego? John Brooks here, Congressional Candidate District 53. We are 6 days out from the election. It's February 27th. Today's 27th. And let me just catch you up on what has been going on. Let's do this. So I think the last time we spoke, I was coming from the Environmental Dems Club meeting. Since then, I've been to maybe three or four other ones, Uptown Dems, Young Dems, Dem Dem, Some Dem, I'm making those up, but a few of them. And even though most of them have already made endorsements in the race, I wanted them to hear my platform. So I kept it real, told them about climate change is not going away, people, and you need someone up there that's strong and that can take care of it. And here's why I think I'm that person. One, I have more life experience than anybody in the race. I have more Washington office experience than anybody in the race. I have more federal government experience than anybody in the race. And most importantly, I have more environmental experience. That's what I do. That was my thing. So you should be voting for me. What else? I got an endorsement, all right, a key endorsement. A group called Equal gave me an endorsement. They're about equal rights for all. And they're national, so I don't know, 9,000 or plus members nationwide. And they interviewed me and totally went against the system and didn't look at the money, didn't look at the endorsements from other groups or anything, just listened to what the candidate had to say. And I think if you do that, you're going to come up with the same conclusion. I'm the strongest person to represent District 53. My motives are pure, right? So what am I going to do the last 6 days of this election? Well, I'm out every night, not drinking, but talking to people. And I find that people are more receptive to hearing what I have to say if they're more relaxed and just chilling out. So I went to 7 Grand, but the event my buddy was putting on is called Jazz and Cocktails, I think, I can't remember. And so I introduced his group, and then I introduced myself, and people were like, oh, Congress. And they came up to me. So I might be onto something here. When I win this election and change the paradigm of how things are done, this is going to be in the playbook. You got to talk to people straight up, man. They don't want any bullshit. They don't want to hear any election rhetoric, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to fight for that. And you know, no, man. How real are you? So went out last night to Prohibition, same thing, and tonight I'm going out to Boy Rex Brewery for Latin Jazz. I haven't played in like 2 months, so my chops are really weak, but it's okay. They weren't that good in the beginning. Yeah, putting out signs, talking to people, hitting up all these different groups on Meetup and LinkedIn and Instagram and Facebook and everything, just saying, hey guys, here I am. They go, oh, see, they didn't know. There's a lot of ads out there for two other candidates, so I shall not name them. But one has already raised $1 million, and if you recall, I talked about this before, that congressional races, it's not unheard of for candidates to raise $1 million or more to get this seat. And I gotta ask you something. Who's gonna put $1 million investment into getting a job that only pays $174,000? Where is the return on the investment? I'll leave that to your imagination. We should have term limits, and we should have no money in politics. It should be publicly funded, or if you want money to stay in, the candidate can only spend as much money as the job pays. That would limit all this big spending, and that would actually give you, the voter, more choices, because all the candidates we covered at that time, and not just a few leading candidates, the ones who have raised the most money or have gotten the most endorsements because of the money they raised or the names, the people they know, or the position they held, but absolutely nothing to do with their qualifications. Nothing to do with their qualifications. So there you have it. I'm gonna keep it short because I got a lot of work to do, and sleep is also important. So till next time, peace out.